Hello children, let us do the practice book of the prepositions of unit 6 and it is page number 35. Yes, so if you see the worksheet 1 here, you can see the pictures there. What pictures, what are the sentences you said? Just see that the cherries are the bowl, the rats jumped the river, and the boy is standing the bench. So when you are reading these sentences, do you feel any sense in that, children? No, not at all. Why? Because there is something missing around, right? That is what we have learned in the grammar book, right? Do you think the above sentences make sense? No. Now compare these sentences with the following. The cherries are in the bowl. The rats jumped into the river. The boy is standing on the bench, right? So when you say here in, into, on, when you add them, they made a sense in the sentence, right? So those words are called as prepositions, right? So those are called prepositions. Okay, so what is a preposition? We have learned already, a preposition shows the relation between a noun or pronoun with another word in a sentence. Now coming to 36 page, you see some prepositions: in, on, at, under, below, behind, over, near, into, in front of, upon, beside, between, after, before, right? So when you see some pictures here, some examples are given, you see below some pictures are given, right? So in that, you can see here, the puppy is in the basket, the puppy is sitting on the table, right? And the puppy is sitting near the basket and the puppy is behind the basket, right? Then the puppy is between the two baskets. When you see the pictures, you can easily identify, right? Then you see here, coming to the next page, yeah, the puppy is sitting near the table. The puppy is sitting near the table. Yeah, here the puppy is sitting. Here it is sitting under the table. Here the puppy is sleeping beside its mother. The puppy is jumping over the box. The puppy is going into the kennel. And the puppy is running around the basket. Right? So all the bold words in the sentences, they are called as prepositions. Okay, children? Now, here you see, underline the prepositions in the following sentences. Underline the prepositions in the following sentences. Yes. What is the first sentence here? The little boy hid behind his mother, right? So the little boy hid behind. So you have to underline behind here. This is the preposition. Then the people gathered in the stadium. In is the preposition. Humpty Dumpty sat on a wall. If I say Humpty Dumpty sat a wall, no, sat on a wall. Don't stand near the electric pole. Don't stand near. The near is showing the connection between don't stand and the electric pole. The books were arranged on the shelf. Where? On the shelf. Here, the books were arranged in the bookshelf. So this shows the relation where the books were arranged, either on the bookshelf or in the book rack. Distribute the chocolates among the students. Distribute the chocolates among the students. Okay, coming to the next page, that is, yes, the next page is page number 38, children. Okay, here, coming to here. Yes, here you see here. Just a minute, children. Yeah. Let me go to little back. Yes. Sorry for the interruption here. Distribute the chocolates. Distribute the chocolates between the two brothers. The princess was locked inside the castle. Okay. July comes after June. Then the birds flew over the field. Rohit is sitting beside his father. The river water is flowing above the danger mark. The river water is flowing below the danger mark. The shooter aimed at the target. So these are called as prepositions, children. Okay. So we have to underline like that. Now coming to the next worksheet, you can see a picture here, children. You observe the picture here. Okay. After observing the picture, you just find out the given questions here, right? What are given here? Observe the picture and correct option in the following sentences. The ball is under the table or below the table. You have to tick the correct one. See the ball where it is. It is under the table. So you have to tick under. Okay, now you can see the basket. Basket is on the table or in the table? It is on the table. So you have to tick on over there, children, right? Then I shall go to the next page. You watch the picture, right? Here you see. The apples are into the basket or in the basket. The apples are in the basket. So you have to put tick mark there, right? The apples are in the basket. The wall clock is between the calendar and the painting, or the wall clock is among the calendar and the painting. It is between the calendar and the painting. Next, the painting is hanging near the window or on the window. The painting is hanging near the window. Then there is a computer at the corner of the room. In the corner of the room, you'd say at the corner of the room. Then there is a pen stand on the table or in the table. There's a pen stand on the table and it is beside the computer. Then there is a shoe rack behind the curtain. You can see in the picture, children. Fine. So this is what we have to do here. Now let me clear the drawings and I shall go to the next part. Now you see the another picture, children. Look at the picture. This is of page number 39. Look at the picture carefully and fill in the blanks with appropriate prepositions from the 8 box given on the next page. So what is the first one here? You can see different cats at different positions was given, right? So kitten 1, if you see the numbers were also given. Kitten 1, where is kitten 1 sitting? Kitten 1 sitting in the drawer, right? In the drawer. So you have to use that. Kitten 1 is sitting in the drawer. So that you have to write. Here I can see, here see. This is 1. Kitten 1 is sitting inside the drawer. Okay. So you have to write here inside. Okay. Inside, I'll just write a text over here. Yeah. INSIDE. Inside. Okay, children. Then I will be going for the next page where you'll find the different pictures. Yeah. Okay. So I'll just clear the drawings. Yes. Now, kitten 2. Where is kitten 2 sitting? It is sitting on the carpet. You first see the picture, children. Kitten 2 is sitting on the drawer, on the carpet. So here I will be writing on. Fine. Then kitten 3 is sleeping. Kitten 3, if you see the picture, kitten 3 is sleeping under the bed, children. You see the picture under the bed. Then kitten 4 is jumping on the cushion. So you have to write here on. Then kitten 5, if you see kitten 5, it is sitting under the table. So you have to write under. Then if you go to kitten 6, what it is doing? Kitten 6 is after the cat. So you have to write after, is running after the cat. Then kitten 7 is running dash the bottle of, running around the bottle of the milk. Around. You can write running round or running around. Then kitten 8 sitting in front of the television. Sitting in front of. In front of is also a preposition, right? Then kitten 9. Is kitten 9 what it is doing? It is looking at the jar, at the cookie jar. Kitten 10 is jumping. It is jumping. It's just coming out of the box. Jumping out of the box. Jumping out of the box. That way you have to answer this, children. Okay. So Yes, next part. I'm going for the next part. Very simple. You can answer here. The following sentences have been taken from Nina is the winner lesson of my English reader. Underline all the prepositions. So what we have to underline here, let us see. What we will underline, we'll see, okay? So I will be underlining. Nina was running ahead of all the participants and just behind her was Medha. The second beat, the chief guest called Nina to the stage. The girl behind Medha crossed the finishing point and the spectators sat on chairs around the racing track. These are the prepositions in that particular lesson, children. Okay, so these are the prepositions which has to be underlined. Then coming to worksheet 3 of your page number 40. Worksheet 3 of page number 40, you can see here. Answer the following questions and circle the prepositions in your answer. One example is done for you. Where do you keep your school shoes? Under the almirah or sometimes on the shelf near the staircase. So under, on and near were circled. The same way, you write your own answer and underline the and circle the proposition. Where do you keep your school dress? So where do you keep your school dress? So just I will write here in my cupboard. So I'll just write like this. So when I write like this, I know that in is the preposition. So I will just circle it. So here I'm going to circle. Just a second, children. Yeah. Yeah. In my cupboard, you have to underline in, children. You can do it. You please underline it. Then coming to here, where do you keep your books? Yeah, I keep my books in my shelf or under my table. I'll just write like that, under my table. So I'll just write here under my table. Okay, so I'll do that under my table. So under my table. So under is a preposition. Where do you keep your pens, pencil, stationery? I keep my pens, pencil, stationery on the table, comma, in the pen stand. Inside, not required. In the pen stand. So this way we can write the prepositions, children. It is your own way of writing. So you can write. Okay, you can write there. Then coming to next question, you see Dhruv has lost his new set of sketch pens. Can you suggest some places where he could have kept them? One example is given below. In his bag, yes, in his bag, then on the table or on the bench. Okay, I can say that on the bench he might find his, sketches. Or then you can say under the bench. Sometimes maybe they fell down, so under the table or bench, whatever you can see. If he's in the school, imagine that it is under the bench. I might feel that they are in the pencil box. So I'll write in the pencil box. You have to use prepositions, children. Okay, in the pencil box. Then I feel like beside his lunch bag. I might feel right. So I use beside. His lunch bag or school bag, beside his lunch bag or school bag. Then I can write here, what else I can write here, like under, below. I used on the book, suppose. So this way, any preposition you can use, children. It is not like that you have to use the same thing. Any other prepositions also you can use. Understand? Okay. Now coming to the next part here. I will clear this first. Yeah. Now you see, read the following sentences. I went to the market with my sister. The necklace is made of gold. I have bought this marker pen for you. Could you please collect my dress from the tailor? Here, to, with, of, for, from. These are all also called as prepositions, children. Okay. So when these are all called prepositions, here you see, do it yourself. Something else is given here. We'll just catch up that. You see here, do it yourself. Here, what is given? Underline the prepositions in the following story. Now we have to underline the preposition. So let us underline. What a sparrow family lived in a nest on the top of a mango tree. Here, of also preposition. In front of a small hut, the family included the father sparrow, the mother sparrow, and three baby sparrows. Chi-Chi, the youngest among the three babies, was also the naughtiest of them all. She would often play pranks on the people of the village, people of the village, and tease little children. She would pluck leaves or small fruits from the trees and throw them at the people's heads. Sometimes she would pick small children's marbles, put them in her beak, and fly over the fields across the village before finally throwing them into the river. Everybody in the village was tired of Chi-Chi's mischiefs. Even Chi-Chi's parents scolded her for being so naughty. So these are the different prepositions we have to underline, children. Okay, these are the different prepositions we have to underline. Fine. Now I will be going to the last part of this prepositions exercise. Complete the following poem by filling the blanks with appropriate prepositions given in the aid box. This is a poem on ants written by Ambika Lal. Look dash the little black ants. You can see the aid box. So what can be suitable here, children? Look, yes, look at the black ants. Look at the black ant, little black ants creeping along the corner. They are just creeping along the corner in a line, one behind the other. You can use behind, one after the other. That is one behind the other. They march steadily on the pail. A pail means like a cup-like thing. On the pail, and don't you dare go near one. If you really wanted to go near one, what happens? Or touch its tiny tail, for then it will surely sting you and make you cry and wail. Wail means shout. Okay, so once you go to near an ant and touch it, what it tries? It tries to bit you, right? So this is the poem, and this way we have to use the prepositions, children. Okay, so this is what we have learnt in the practice book. So please complete the answers. You can do it after all, because prepositions are very important and easy to learn. You will understand also the connection of the sentence is made properly only by using prepositions, children. Okay, remember this concept and hope you have understood well. Thank you so much for listening, children. Take care of yourself, stay home, stay safe.